Hello guys! When you work with materials in Houdini, using the viewport to preview your work is very useful. Even more, if your computer is not powerful enough to have the IPR active while you're working with your file. That is why sometimes working with Redshift and not being able to see the materials in the viewport can become an annoying process. After watching Houdini's OpenGL masterclass, I realized that something could be done about it, so let's try it. We will start with a grid mesh. Keep in mind that the mesh needs to have UVs. First, we need to create a Redshift botnet. Inside the network, add a material node and connect it to the surface. Let's assign the material to the mesh. Now we need to add some parameters. In the botnet, right-click and go to Edit Parameter Interface. In the parameter interface, let's add a folder, a toggle, and a file image. In the toggles label, let's write Use Diffuse. And in the tag section, click Building Tags. Filter the parameters by diffuse. In the Diffuse Texture Layers folder, select the Use Diffuse Map tag. And once you add it, you need to change the number sign to 1. Then in the file image, change the label to Diffuse Map. And in the tags, add the texture tag under Diffuse Texture Layers. You also need to change the number sign to 1. Apply the changes to the interface and now search your texture map and enable the diffuse. And that's it! Now you can see the textures in the viewport. If you're having problems visualizing the texture, don't forget that your mesh needs UVs. Let's add another map. This time, we'll add a displacement. Same as before, go to the Edit Parameter interface. We add a toggle and a file image. For the label in the toggle, we write Use Displacement, and in the tags, instead of filtering by diffuse, we filter by displace, and select Use Displacement Map. In the file image label, we'll write Displacement Map, and in the tags, we'll select Displacement Map. Apply the changes. Then search for your map and enable the displacement. Okay, the scale of the displacement is way over the top. We need to fix this. Go once again to the parameter interface and add a float. In the label, we'll write displacement scale. And in the tags, choose display scale. Click apply, and now we can control the displacement. It's important to remember that this only works in the viewport. That means that if I start the IPR, I won't see the textures. In order to see them, we need to link the textures to the material inside the botnet. For example, for the diffuse, we go inside and add a texture node. Now we need to choose the file name. So let's copy the diffuse texture parameter from the botnet and paste it as a relative reference in the texture sampler. Enable the gamma and set it as a sRGB. Now we'll connect the texture sampler output to the diffuse color. And now we can see the texture in the IPR. I'll stop the video and connect all the other parameters we created and be right back. As you can see, now we can control our material with the botnet parameters we created and see the results in both the viewport and the IPR. I hope you find this useful. That's all for now in the Houdini's Quick Tip series. See you later, alligators!